So I feel like I'm beating a dead horse with this story, but basically, as you all know, Donald Trump's last Hail Mary was this weird lawsuit from Texas, where basically Texas alleges that other states violated their own state constitution by offering mail-in voting to their residents in the middle of a pandemic. I'm oversimplifying it, but that's basically it. I mean, the case was bogus. They didn't have standing. It wasn't going to go anywhere. And predictably, it failed. And the Supreme Court directly shot Donald Trump down. So if you're Donald Trump and you are going to maintain that you didn't actually lose and the election was stolen from you, now is the time where, when you have nowhere left to go, you start changing what you say. You know, look, I think we won this election, but the fight's over. From now we focus on 2024 or something. So what is he doing? How is he changing his rhetoric with regard to this election fraud scheme? Well, he's not. He's not changing anything. Even after the Supreme Court shot him down, he's saying the same exact things. These are just some of the tweets that he put out. We have just begun the fight. He tweeted this after the Supreme Court shot him down. The Supreme Court really let us down. No wisdom, no courage. I won the election in a landslide, but remember, I only think in terms of legal votes. Oh, okay. Not all of the fake voters and fraud that miraculously floated in from everywhere. What a disgrace. Who is a worse governor, Brian Kemp of Georgia or Doug Ducey of Arizona? These are two rhino Republicans who fought against me and the Republican Party harder than any Democrat. They allowed states that I won easily to be stolen. Never forget. Vote them out of office. And then he says, most corrupt election in U.S. history. He's literally going to continue saying the same thing. And by the time you watch this video, the Electoral College will have already confirmed Joe Biden's victory, but he's still going to keep saying the same thing. Oh, don't you worry. We're still fighting. We're just getting started. We're going to win this. There's like another lawsuit up our sleeve or something. Look, if you are actually going to run for president in 2024, you could start talking about that now so you don't look as delusional, but he's not changing anything. And in an interview with Brian Kilmeade of Fox News, which is extremely entertaining to watch, he says the most ironic thing I've ever heard him say.
When you look at this fight, though, you have 77% of Trump supporters who believe you won the election, according to a Fox poll.
There's a
rally right now in Washington for that. Do you worry about the country being divided as if it goes to inauguration and they still feel that way and you still feel that way?
No, I worry about the country having an illegitimate president. That's what I worry about. A president that lost and lost badly. This wasn't like a close election. You look at Georgia. We won Georgia big. We won Pennsylvania big. We won Wisconsin big. We won it big.
But your guys,
we won all of these states.
But do you think your legal team has proven that?
Well, we never get a chance to prove it because a judge will say, well, I'm sorry, you don't have standing. Like, how about me? Texas and all of these states, 18 or 19 altogether, they come in. Think how nice that is, where they actually come in and they say, we want to support you, sir, because you're important to this country. We want to support you. They go in and they say, the states don't have standing and I don't have. I'm president of the United States. I just got 75 million votes. The biggest number of votes in the history of our country ever gotten by a sitting president.
It's funny how his vote totals are accurate, but since Joe Biden got more votes than him, it can't possibly be accurate. So if the same systems, if you use AP or Decision Desk, if they are accurately reporting your vote totals, why wouldn't you also believe that they're accurately reporting Joe Biden's vote totals? Oh, well, there's an easy answer for that, Mike. It's because they're reporting the illegal votes, too. But look at what he said. I worry about the people having an illegitimate president. That's what I worry about. A president that lost and lost badly. This wasn't like a close election. The irony just flew right over his head because if he were successful at getting Republicans from various states to appoint their own electors that would vote for him, then you're basically disenfranchising millions of people and killing democracy, quite literally. But that's what he wanted. But yet he's worried about the people having an illegitimate president and a president that lost badly. You lost badly. You lost multiple states. So if this effort were even to be successful, you know, he would have a better case, even though he wouldn't have a case at all, but you'd have a better argument if it came down to like one state, like in the 2000 election. There was one state, Florida, and that's all that Bush had to focus on, but you have multiple states. So the fact that it's not even that close in actuality, and he's still maintaining that he won, it's embarrassing. And I don't necessarily care what Donald Trump says. I care about the consequences of his words, right? Because he has convinced a lot of Republicans that he actually won this election, which is shocking, because of course he didn't. If the establishment was going to rig any election, wouldn't it have been back in 2016 to stop you from becoming president in the first place? I mean, all you have to do is think about these allegations of fraud for a minute or two, and you realize that on their face, they're absolutely ridiculous. He also says, you look at Georgia, we won Georgia big, we won Pennsylvania big, we won Wisconsin big. No, you did not. You literally did not win these states. And by saying this, he knows it's not true, but he's trying to get people to think that he's true. And part of this, and I don't know if Trump is even this savvy and really playing four-dimensional chess to this extent, but I think that if he actually does run in 2024, he's setting himself up now to clear the field in the Republican primary and say, look, I'm the rightful president. I should be president right now, but this election was stolen from me. So anyone who's running against me, they're complicit in the Democratic Party's fraud. I mean, maybe that's what he's doing, but I just want to ask, at what point does his family step in? They know that what he's doing is delusional. Like, part of me thinks that Donald Trump really believes that he won. Maybe it's cognitive dissonance, but another part of this, like, you see what he's saying? This is not a well man. Regardless, if this is all, you know, him playing politics and political theater, what he's doing is harmful. So after the election, there were reports that Don Jr. or maybe Ivanka would step in and stage an intervention and get him to accept the results. What happened to that? I mean, this is cruel. You see someone in your family, regardless if he's the president or not, clearly unwell, saying things that make him seem delusional. At what point does the family get blame? And I think we're beyond that. Why isn't Ivanka, the person who's basically the only one who's seemingly able to talk sense into him, not saying, Dad, it's over. I know that you think that you won this election, but you're not going to be the president. Come January 21st of 2021, you're out. So now it's time to think about what you're going to do on that day. But I mean, we get nothing. Like, if a member of my family was spiraling publicly like this, I would be embarrassed for them. And out of love, I would try to rein them in. Right? Talk some sense into them. But we're not getting that. Now Trump's family, I think they're intimidated by him and they don't want to confront him. They're just letting him like spew this bullshit when they know it's not true. You know, as entertaining as it is, this really is going to do long-term damage to our democracy. It is. Because if Americans don't believe that the process is legitimate and credible, then that's when you start seeing democracy fall apart. And there are legitimate reasons why you can be dissatisfied with our democracy. I don't like our electoral institutions. I think they're biased against third and fourth parties. I think that, you know, winner-take-all systems are just inherently anti-democratic because they limit options when you should have a plethora of options in a democracy. But putting all of that aside, if people don't even believe that their votes are going to be counted, that's a problem. It does not bode well for the long-term health of democracy.
Mike is the worst progressive on YouTube. Please don't subscribe to him or become a patron. David Dole is so much better. Trust me, folks. He's doing a great job. He really is. Okay?